So first things first, I got the stocking cap from Hair City in Leeds. And if you've got a local hair shop, you should check there for them because you can get two in a pack for a pound. Looking like one chocolate egg for the Easter season. And then I applied my Got To Be Glow gel, but girls, please don't put this directly on your hairline because your edges will get ripped out. Like, Got To Be Glow is not something to play with. But before anybody tries to come for me, I know my nails are in some disgusting state, and if you know me, you'll know that normally I have a nice long ass full set on, but one of my acrylics snapped and it ripped off half my nails, so right now I'm in a bit of a state of trauma. I'm recovering.
And if you're wondering why my lips are moving, it's because I've got my TV on in the background playing music.
If like me you don't have all day to do this type of shit, use a hairdryer on a cool setting to make the glue dry quicker. Cause not gonna lie, the drying process for this whole stocking cap method takes the piss. I was doing it for like hours. This video is not a true reflection of how long it took.
From your looking at my face, you see I'm the Leviathan. Well, I said, come on, sir, Glazer, anti-federation. Strictly rules and culture, play upon night station.
I told you my lips were moving because I was having a little skank out and listening to music whilst I was doing this. But just like how there's always that one piece of hair sticking out, obviously I had to have that one piece of the stocking cap that didn't want to stick down properly. So I had to put some more gel on that and then dry it with the hairdryer again. But this is why it's important to make sure that all of the stocking cap is dry and stuck to your head properly, because that shit is annoying. But anyways, this is a red frontal wig that I made a few months ago. I think it's like 12 inches or something. But the aim is to have the stocking cap match the colour of your face as best as possible. So I just used the old foundation to try and do that. I know it's better to use powder, but I don't really use that in my makeup, so I don't have any. And then I just put the spray on top of the foundation and blow dried it so that it wouldn't be shifting anywhere, so the colour would stay.
Does anybody else's family members do this chicken neck spank though? Because I can't call.
And then I put my Got To Be glued around the perimeter of the stocking cap to stick down my wig and secure it, because I'll be shaking my head a lot. And I feel like the gel just always works best with the spray, so I use that after. Obviously, another needed skank spray.
bitch. I know I'm looking crazy at the moment, but I'll fix it all.
In the street with a wedding ring, and she hit the box, city bake. Are you down to cheat? He looked in the eye, chivalry. Is it really there?
And when using Got to Be Blue to stick your wig down, I feel like it's easier sticking it if you do it in sections instead of one big piece.
Just to show you mine, I'm not having it. So in love with you like a drug addict. So you treat me so unreal. What she do, I do better.
And then boom, it's a whole new bitch in the place. I had to do a little bit of fleek. Just some eyebrows and concealer because I need a new foundation. But just because, you know, you've always got to plug yourself, these eyelashes are named after me. They're in the style Storm, and the link for them will be in the description box below. You know, I really don't care about who's gonna come for me. I'm gonna swear by bonding glue for life because did you see how quickly I just dashed that eyelash on? No ramping. Boom. Next eyelash on like that. But can you tell that I miss Jamaica? I know you can see the white residue at the moment from the Got to Be Glue, but you can get that off with some rubbing alcohol. But are you like seeing how my eyes are moving? I don't even know how I did that. I went and did some baby hairs off camera because they were just taking the piss, not being cooperative, but then I finally got a little something out of them. But then it's important that you wrap a headscarf around your edges and then let them cook up and all of that good stuff.
Just eat it. Looks like a cocoa on.
Sorry, please just pray the glow.
So I'm finished. Like, I know this isn't the best stocking cap method, and I could think of like 10 people that have done a better one than me, but still I had fun shooting the video. Don't cut off too much down here of the stocking cap, because then that meant that I couldn't stick it down as much as I wanted to. So boom. I hope you enjoyed this video. Follow my Instagram at storm_henry. And my Twitter, storm_henry, my Snapchat at storm_henry. And yeah, subscribe to my channel, like, comment, share, bitch.